This is the point where the levels start to become annoying. Like in a lot of levels before this, the fudge pops are an indication of what you need to do. Since this is the only thing you can freeze, we're just gonna move ahead and do that. Of course, these guys are going to try and freeze and kill you the entire time you're doing this, but what you need to do is get the size block moving horizontally, like so, and we're gonna freeze it so that it lines up with this spot below. And now we'll have to... I hate these guys. Anyway, what we need to do is get this moving vertically now, and once it gets into position here, create the pillar so we can move it to this next open spot. Now, let's go ahead and get this moving. We're gonna wait until it comes back. Ugh! I hate that it's right in front of that spawn point. Let's get this here. Actually, that is not right. Let's go ahead and clear out this little pillar, freeze it again, now get this moving. Now that they're out of position, it should be a little easier to do. Oh god, you annoying son of a bitch. Ugh. This can be a pain in the ass. Because you have to wait until it goes to the left spring and bounces back. Otherwise, it's not going to line up with the spot below, and you're not going to be able to kick it into one of the gaps. Now let's get this moving. When it comes back down, block it with the pillar, kick it over, and we're out of here. And this is not going to get much better as these levels go on, I can tell you that right now. Also, there are going to be cuts constantly because I kept dying trying to do some of these. This one in particular, if you're not ready for it right away, you will die. See that spiky thing in front of you? You have to run after it the entire time you're doing this. Because if you don't, there's nowhere else for you to run. It's going to hit you, it's going to kill you, and you're going to have to start this all over. What you need to do is, as you move around this island, keep stopping briefly to freeze the noggle so that the birds will kick it into place and eventually form a bridge. Now, I died twice trying to do this. Once because I forgot what level this was, and twice because I kept hitting the birds instead of the noggles. Ugh. There we go. God damn. Yeah, that's something I do, is just create the ice pillar so that it can't come in. Of course, he made the bridge to the other side, so that was rendered entirely pointless. Now, this next level I got stuck on, and, actually, I'm not surprised that I got stuck on it. It's not entirely obvious what you need to do. Now, clearly you need to get an ice block into that watery gap where the three hammers are. Now, the question is, how do you do it? Well, the first thing you're going to notice that you can do is create the ice block here and put a pillar here. And kick this up into the hammer as soon as you avoid this bomb. The bombs are like the freezing guys in the other level. They will annoy you to no end. Now, that ice block just came right back to where we were, so we're gonna have to do this again. We're gonna have to block it with an ice pillar, assuming that the bombs don't blow it up. Now, that ice block is in position. What we need to do now is be able to get another ice block moving, and get that going, and kick it right after that other ice block. I got stuck on this for the longest time because I was not kicking the previous ice block soon enough. I would wait for too long, the hammers would move out of position, and I would end up having to suicide because I would run out of time. This is another level where if you do it wrong, you're going to have to suicide and do it all over again. You have all these ice blocks, you have no way to regenerate them if they should disappear, and what you have to do is kick them into each other in the right order so that you have one block facing that gap. If you do it wrong, you're going to end up with two ice blocks right next to each other, and when you kick them, they'll both go into the wall and they'll both break. Be careful for that one spiky thing, because when they go over each other, they'll just fly right across the stage. Now, I hope you like hammers, because in this level, there's not one, not two, not three hammers. There are 8 hammers. 8! This one is really just a matter of taking it step by step. In fact, you'll notice several cuts in this as I am pausing repeatedly to make sure that what I'm doing is the right order. You basically need to take a moment to pause the game and figure out individually which, on a hammer by hammer basis, where you want to go with your block. Now see, I just did it wrong because I completely forgot about these 2 hammers to the side. You'll have to mentally progress through it both from the point where the ice block is and from the point where you will need to make the final hit on that hammer that I'm just walking past now to be able to get it into the gap. Now what you see me doing right now is being a paranoid asshole about this, because the last couple times I tried this, I ran out of time. Even though it seems really obvious what you're supposed to do. You know what, for time's sake, I'm going to skip all of this and go right to when I got the solution. Now, at first I thought you had to move one of the hammers as the sequence was going, but no, you don't have to. It's not one of those puzzles. And at this point, we should be good to go to face off against the Wizard King. As soon as we talk to... Yeah, these are Legos that we're apparently talking to. And how do we get into the world of the Wizard King? Simple. Magic rain. Where does the magic rain come from? Wherever. You don't really know. It just sort of happens. I'm not gonna question it. Now the thing about magic rain is it has a very peculiar reaction when it lands on the wizard's head. It causes several either rainbows or LJN logos to appear. Could go either way. The logos then turn into music notes, circle around the head, and cause it to explode. Or crumble. It's kind of hard to tell which. Now I want you to picture the biggest letdown of your life. Well, maybe not of your life, just a really big letdown. Now, this big bad Wizard King that we've been going through 70 plus levels to get to, what does he look like? A very small snowman with a staff and a bucket on its head. How horribly disappointing. Now he launches these balls that bounce around the screen and can be frozen to turn into these huge ice blocks. In that respect, this is a pretty easy fight. But like the clown when he was doing the flip attack toward you in the second level, he goes airborne and you can't hit him. And not only that, you'll have to guide him away from the ice blocks that you create, so that you'll be able to hit them with them later. Now, you saw that the balls can bounce off of the ice blocks. So what you might want to try to do is time it so that... Why did the block break? Whatever. Is time it so that it just bounces off the wall when you freeze it. That way there will be a gap behind it you can walk behind to shelter yourself from additional balls, as well as be able to get behind it and kick it at the Wizard King. And I will tell you now, this guy takes a fair amount of hits. This isn't going to be like before where we could just do like 3 hits or 4 hits. Nah, we're gonna be here a while. And he's going to move faster after you when he goes airborne, and he's going to do it more often too. Gets to the point where sometimes, you'll have to, like, lead him in one direction first, and then cut back to the other direction that you actually want to go to. Ah, that's another thing you can do, is freeze it at the top of the screen, so that you can kick it sideways into him. Probably should have mentioned that before. See how fast he's moving now? And you've got to move out of the way, because he always goes straight back. You notice that by just running away, I have barely enough time to be able to get out of the way. That's why you want to misdirect him a little bit. And it is getting harder to freeze these things off of the back of the wall. At this point, you're probably better off just going for the freeze it against the back of the wall thing. Unless you can catch it really early in its attack like that. Ah, yes. And now I am just going to shut up while the ending plays. Next time on Kickle, Cubicle, the special stages.